When Christ calls a man, he bids him come and die. Christians are revolutionaries, at odds with the world, willing to suffer anything for the cause. Then Moses called for all the elders of Israel and said to them, "Take a lamb according to your families and kill a Passover. Take some hyssop and dip it in the basin and strike the lintel and the two side posts with the blood that is in the basin. The blood shall be to you for a token upon the house where you are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you."
And the blood has never lost its power. No, never. No, never. Jesus' blood. Its power. No, never. No, never. Jesus' blood avails for sin forever. It will never lose its power.
Jesus, being in agony, prayed more earnestly, and his sweat was as it were great drops of blood falling down to the ground.
Yeah. Jesus, how on a cross he died. I felt so guilty when I was told that his life for me he sacrificed. Did he know I'd need him so when he lived 2,000 years ago? If he can see me as I am, then why does he love? I learned of the way they treated him, of how they mocked him and they swore, and that they pressed upon his brow crying. That was splintering and so hard, and that they made him carry it upon a back that was marked. On my
And straight away in the morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council, and bound Jesus, and carried him away, and delivered him to Pilate. And Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" And he said unto him, "Thou sayest it." And the chief priests accused him of many things, but he answered nothing. Pilate asked him again, saying, "Answerest thou nothing? Behold how many things they witness against thee." But Jesus yet answered nothing, so that Pilate marveled. And Pilate answered and said again unto them,
"What will ye that I should do unto Jesus, whom you call the King of the Jews?"
"Crucify him!
Crucify him!"
"Why? Why? What evil has he done?"
"He's a blasphemer!"
And so Pilate, willing to content the people, released Barabbas unto them and delivered Jesus, when he had scourged him, to be crucified. And the soldiers led him away into the hall called Praetorium, and they called together the whole band. And they clothed him with purple, and plaited a crown of thorns, and placed it about his head, and began to salute him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they smote him on the head with a reed, and spit upon him, and bowing their knees, worshipped him. And when they had mocked him, they took off the purple from him and put his own clothes on him and led him out to crucify him. And they compelled one, Simon, a Cyrenian, who passed by coming out of the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to bear his cross. And they bring him to the place Golgotha, which is, being interpreted, the place of a skull. And they gave him to drink wine mingled with myrrh, but he received it not. And when they had crucified him, they parted his garments, casting lots upon them, what every man should take. And it was the third hour. And they crucified him! And the superscription of his accusation was written over, "The King of the Jews." And with him, they crucified two thieves, one on his right hand and the other on his left. And the scripture was fulfilled which saith, "He was numbered with the transgressors." And they that passed by railed on him, wagging their heads and saying, "Ah! Thou that destroyest the temple and buildest it again in 3 days, save thyself and come down from the cross." Likewise also, the chief priests, mocking, said amongst themselves with the scribes, "He saved others, himself he cannot save. Let Christ, the King of Israel, descend now from the cross, that we may see and believe." And they that were crucified with him reviled him. And when the sixth hour was come, there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour. And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eloi! "My God!
My
which stood by when they heard it, said, "Behold, he called Elias." And one ran and filled a sponge full of vinegar and put it on a reed and gave him to drink, saying, "Let alone. Let us see whether Elias will come to take him down." And Jesus cried with a loud voice and gave up the ghost.
And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. Incredible mystery is this, that the immortal God should die. I'll never ever be able to explore his strange design.
To sound the depths of love divine. Thank you.
Joanna,